Hi everyone.
Hi.
Welcome to First Job Talks, episode 8 of this year, season 2. We are in this beautiful city called Indore today, and you can see a lot of bright young faces behind us. This is the college, this is IPS Academy, and we've got these wonderful candidates who are in the third year of engineering. So we're going to discuss today about the talent goldmine that is in tier 2 and tier 3 cities of India. Bollywood has all these programs where they talk about Badlapur, they talk about Wazipur, etc. But India has 90% of its talent in all the cities that are not Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore. And today we're going to talk about that. Indian Idol shows us some amazing talent that is there in dance, music, singing. Engineers also come up when you pick up the newspapers. The business headlines talk about people who are from Trichy, who are from Vellore, who are from Jaipur. So India has amazing talent. In the last show, when we were talking to the TA head of DXC, she said that a lot of technology companies come and hire from India. They open large centers in India because India has some of the brightest young folks in technology and engineering. So today we're going to discuss the bright young minds and how they are going to be discovered by companies and how technology is helping in doing all this. And to discuss this, I've got some very interesting people in this room today. We're sitting in the auditorium, by the way, of IPS Academy, Institute of Engineering and Science. So on my right, we have Dr. Archana Kirti Chaudhary. She is a principal. Hi, ma'am.
Hi.
On my left here, we have Deepak Dhanotia. He is the co-founder of a startup called Shop Kirana, which started about 3 years ago in Indore. He himself is an engineer, and we'll be talking to him about his journey in getting his first job and then starting a company in Indore, which is now doing extremely well and has got some very good funding recently. And on my extreme left, we've got a student from IPS, that's Ritik Salicha. Yeah. Ritik has joined, going to be joining a company called Value Momentum. He's recently got a job with them. Congratulations.
Thank you, sir.
Great. So let's start. And like you say this each time, this is an interactive session. Use the chat window on your Facebook page to ask questions to all of us and share your suggestions, comments, and we'll take up all this, you know, as we go along in this conversation. Great. So let's start with you, Ritik. Tell us about your journey in getting to your first job, and tell us about where you are from, which city, and did you find any challenges or any changes because you were from India?
Thank you, sir, for introducing me. Good afternoon, everyone. And I'm Ritik Salicha, and I got my first placement through CoCubes only. I want you to know that I got my first placement after 14 to 15 rejections. I have to hear more rejections at every day-by-day basis in multiple companies. So first of all, I am from Agar Malwa, which is approximately 120 kilometers from Indore. And for higher studies, I have to migrate from Agar to Indore because there is no such facilities in Agar to enhance myself, to grow myself, to improve to the better place, to compete with world. And today's world is so competitive, so I have to migrate to Indore for further studies. Yes, some may face financial problems for migrating and for studying in like cities like Indore and big metro cities. So after studying in IPS Academy, I got so much experience about how we learn such things. There are many things to learn in college life too. And IPS Academy also helped me to improve myself, my personality, my personal development. And after rejections, I was like, for placements, I am preparing like for 2 to 3 months. But first four to five months, I was like normally like, no. I will just go and then come. I will not prepare hard. So that does not work for all because everyone not has same luck. So I tried and after 5 to 6 companies, I examined myself that where I am lagging. So I have to improve that, and I have to face each company's confidently and very prepared. So I face, but again I face rejections and rejection, but I don't disheartened, like, no, I will not. I tried in each and every company, and after 14 to 15 companies, through CoCubes, I don't have to move with resume, like going to these companies and these companies. CoCubes helps me there are many multiple companies connected with CoCubes. So it helps me just try to fill form and give you exams, and for that score, I will apply in companies. So when momentum come, then I will go and my first placement was, it's a very beautiful experience. It's beautifully said, if you got placed in first company, you will take it lightly, okay. But if you got placed after 14 to 15 rejections, then you will, its importance is more bigger than what you got placed in first only. So yeah, it's very beautiful experience, and thank you, sir.
Great, that's fantastic. So many rejections, so try till you succeed. Allah.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Great, okay. So ma'am, you've been with this institute now for almost 20 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what is it like to be teaching in this wonderful institute? What is it that you find that is, the special spark in a city like Indore and the talent in Indore for engineering?
Yeah. So Indore belongs to tier 2 and tier 3 cities, what we call. But what I feel, there is no more difference left between tier 1 and tier 2 and tier 3. The difference is, basically I can say, it is narrowing. And the most important thing which I found in Indore is, in fact, the IPS Academy is one of the premier institute established in 1994 with the sole motto of knowledge, skill and values only. And engineering college is one of the institute of IPS Academy established in 1999. What is the difference? What I found in this institute as compared to others, the most important thing is our president, is the vision of our institute to be the fountainhead of noble ideas, and we are giving more weightage to the fountainhead of noble ideas. Apart from this, our mission is to inculcate values and ethics to the student. And this is the moral responsibility of faculty, of teacher, to inculcate ethics among the students, because everybody is doing work very hard, all the students are studying, everybody is contributing for the success of their life, for the success, contributing for their success, their individual success or the success of the institute. But the most important thing which makes a man different from others is, be focused on your studies, be focused about your mission. I think every day a student or a faculty should contribute at least delta X towards their mission. I think this is this thing I found a lot in this institute. Our president himself is an IITian. He is from IIT Kharagpur. He did his architecture, and because of his degree belongs to an NIT type or reputed institute of India, this makes difference among the characters of our institute, among the characters of our faculties, among the characters of our students. So this is the most important difference which I find in this institute.
Yeah. Wonderful. So we'll talk more about, you know, what's there in the institute that you are doing to make change. We'll talk a bit about that as we come back. Yeah. So Deepak, your journey, let's talk about you first as a person from tier 2, tier 3 city, doing engineering from Indore,
right?
And then obviously starting a startup from Indore. So tell us about your journey and why did you start a startup in Indore? I think that's a question that a lot of us want to know. More from a positive, fascinating point of view, not like saying why did you do it from here.
Right. Thank you first of all for this opportunity. So my personally, basically, I come from a very small village. It's an MP border, MP Rajasthan border. I came to Indore similar to Mamihim to do my studies. I did my engineering from Indore, and at that point in time, basically, the job market, especially for GSITS from the college from which I belong, was good enough. But the one thing that I found among my colleagues at that point was
is companies are selecting, students are not selective about where they want to go, what they want to achieve, and what kind of job they want to go into, and they do not have long-term plans. But my journey was very clear from the day kind of I was in my college. I was selective about the job I want to get into so that I have some long-term plan. And that helped me to get again a job into tier 2. So I was going to Pithampur, a place near to this kind of city, and doing some planning work because I wanted to be a planner initially to do good business. End of kind of 5-10 years. So then I obviously went to Mumbai to do my further studies, and then I did 3-4 years of corporate experience into some multinational companies, and then came into entrepreneurship. But tier 2 helps you to open your wings, to be very honest. The competition is lesser, and when you come from smaller towns, you find space to breathe, to be very honest. And that is what is the reason we again came back as a company to Indore. And even today now we are operating into multiple cities, majorly tier 2, but again we are headquartered in Indore, and hopefully we will be headquartered in Indore for very, very long time. Because against the big corporates or the smartest and fast growing companies, you find some breathing space for yourself to innovate and prove yourself. So that is what is, I feel, a biggest advantage.
Yeah, I agree. And also I think technology, infrastructure, all that is improving in all our cities. So, and you know, given that the government's also looking at smart cities in different parts of India, that's also kind of adding up.
Yes. So when we talk about the size of the opportunity, tier 2 is obviously the biggest for businesses, because there are 5 tier 1. So when we do something good in 1 tier 1 as a business, it is going to be multiplied by 5 times only. But if I do something good in 1 tier 1, my business plan can be multiplied by 30 to 50 cities, because India is a country of many tier 2 cities versus few tier 1 cities.
That's right. 90% plus would be in those cities.
Right.
Yeah.
Indore, we can say, is the fastest growing city in central India.
Right. Yeah.
So fastest growing city.
Lot of corporates coming here, yeah, as well. TCS, yeah. Infosys.
Yeah.
Plus infrastructure.
In fact, Indore is the only city in India where we have IIT and IIM both.
Yeah, and IPS.
Yes, IPS, of course. And IPS.
So from talent side, I had a view when we were discussing internally. So on talent, we have very simple kind of understanding that talent is distributed very randomly.
Yeah.
So it is not tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, tier 4. We find in India especially, the most brightest people have come from tier 4 even. So talent is randomly distributed, and you mentioned it right. Obviously, when these big events like Indian Idol or anything is going, they are going to tier 4 to search the talent. And that even corporate has to put all the efforts, and even co-groups kind of institutes has to put all the efforts to bring the talent from the tier 4, tier 3, because that talent may go into vain if we do not put our effort to bring that talent up front.
Absolutely.
The role of co-groups, what I feel, is very important, not only for the placement, but it is not, there is no boundary, it's not limited up to placement. But the most important thing which the institute like us or the national institute get the importance is the pre-assessment. At least the student should be aware about where he stand. Not only what he or she is doing within the college, that is not equally important. The most important thing is where he stand among the different colleges, among the lakhs of students. That's so that right. Is most important thing which supports us for the development of the student.
Absolutely. So that's like a reality check.
That is a reality
earlier.
Check. That is most important.
Which tells you, okay, now you have to start, yeah, from here and go,
yeah,
somewhere.
Because I am really proud of my students. My students are serving in government sector. My students are serving very good in government sector. Most of the students are IES selected or IPS or IAS selected students. Many of the students are serving public sector, and the most important, I'm really proud about the students who are giving the offers to, who are giving job to our their juniors. They are doing excellent work in private sector also. So this is, everything is possible. Not only getting job is the only criteria. The most important thing is to assess yourself, where you stand, what, how much amount of work is required to improve yourself. That this type of advantage we are getting with the help of the companies like CoCubes. So thanks to CoCubes.
Thank you.
Yeah.
No, absolutely. I think technology, infrastructure, and the drive to do something,
yeah,
I think can be anywhere. It doesn't need to be geographically in any one city,
yeah, yeah, yeah,
and that can go anywhere from there.
So most of the students belongs to very remote places who are performing very good in government sector, public or private. Most of them are not belonging to metros.
Yeah.
That belongs to very small place. It doesn't matter from where you, which place you belong. The most important thing is you should be focused. And the most important thing which is lacking in the students is dedication. If you are dedicated toward your job, if you are contributing towards your mission, nobody stops you.
That's right. Yeah, that's unstoppable.
Yeah.
So one of the things that we hear from, you know, when we talk to talent acquisition heads and HR heads in companies,
yes,
they, one of the mindsets that we hear sometimes or get to understand is that they think that language is a barrier in small towns.
I don't think language is a barrier.
What is that? Yeah, that's my question.
I don't think language is a barrier. Language is never be the barrier. Obviously, you must be able to present yourself.
Right.
This is important. But the most important thing which survive long is your positive attitude towards the job. Your attitude towards learning. The most of the companies identify the student. They very well know you are not able to solve their problem directly when you join any company.
Right.
But what they see in you, in every individual, the basically the attitude towards their mission.
Yeah. So
whether they are really interested to work hard, what actually is their learning capability?
Yeah, learnability.
Basically,
yeah.
Learning ability rather.
That's right.
Say.
Yeah.
That is basically required. Because in most of the campus interviews, the most important thing which is required is aptitude, GD, seminars, presentations. That is most important.
Right.
So I don't think language is barrier. The most important thing is the attitude and the confidence.
Yeah. I think
that you will win the race. You will be, kal honge, hum honge kamyab.
Yeah.
That is the most important thing.
That's right. And aajkal, it's apna time aayega. Right?
Yes, apna time aayega.
Great.
And apna time zarur aayega.
Bilkul.
Yeah.
Ritik, so what did you see when you were preparing and you were going through all these, you know, you said so many times you were not succeeding.
Yes.
So what was playing on your mind? What were others thinking in your class? Ki yaar apna kuch nahi ho sakta ye wo. How did you guys motivate yourself? What did you tell yourself? Kaise hoga?
After facing rejections, one thing is clear in mind that I want placement anyhow. I will try and I will grab each and every opportunity. I will not do like that. Yeah, these companies come in for recruiting one student over 1,000 students. I can be that one student. You have to keep confidence and you have to appear with confidence. You will not like, how can I appear in that company? This is also a big company. You have to be confident and you have to not think yourself lower than other. So first important thing is confidence. This can be changed, this mindset can be changed by thinking that you are thinking that you are down to others. Don't think you are competing with only your level and you are superior, you are more than superior to whom you are competing. So be confident and while approaching any company, bigger or small, be confident and give your best, you will definitely succeed. So this is the only mindset I am. I completely keep confident me by repeating this sentence like that. No, one day apna time aayega.
Wonderful. Well, aapka time aa gaya.
Yes.
But I think the most important thing, students should be serious about their placement from the first year onwards.
That's right.
That's why we arrange pre-assessment tests from the first year itself. Something jadu nahi hone wala hai on the last day. So if you work really hard about the 4 years and we are giving the opportunity to explore yourself in all the parameters in aptitude or domain or quantum or so many other things, so that you will be able to understand where you stand and how much practice or how much learning is required for meeting your target. So this you have to start from the first year itself, and for that pre-assessment are being introduced from the first year itself. Not it's not preferable to join in the last year because you have already lost 3 years.
That's right. I think that's a very powerful point. That ekdam jadoo nahi hone wala in the last year that suddenly you'll find a job.
Yes.
That will only happen when you start from the first year. You know what your gaps are and how you're going to work towards it.
Yeah.
Great. So Deepak, what all cities are you running from right now? What all cities is Shop Kirana in right now?
We are operating into like Indore, Bhopal, Jaipur.
Okay. Oh, interesting. All three are wonderfully tier two cities.
Right.
So what's your business model? How many people do you have and do you hire them in those cities itself?
Yes, yes. So we have obviously the people in operations. We are an e-commerce company. So we operate e-commerce, B2B e-commerce platform. And so people in operations has to be hired locally because they are comfortable, and sometime in operations you have to do kind of multiple shifts and all of that. But at headquarter we almost have kind of 70 people working from Indore headquarter, and almost 80 people, 70 to 80 people on operations on roll of roll. We hire from majorly kind of the cities because the retention is very, very good in tier 2. So once you hire people and give them very good atmosphere and kind of working condition and innovative atmosphere, I think people feel very comfortable working with the startups.
Right. Yeah, and it's employment in my own city.
Right.
That makes a big difference too. You don't have to go and stay in another city for that.
Yes. So nowadays, like what we think is there was from in India, there was a brain drain. So people were going from India to other countries to work, and then that brain drain was happening from tier 2 to tier 1 also at a very, very fastest pace, to be very honest. So most of the people who are very intelligent and kind of smart people were going and shifting to tier 1. Now there is a negative or reverse brain drain happening at both places, like people coming back to India also, and people from tier 1.
They're moving towards tier 2 and tier
2. So they also want to come back to tier 2 and have a better life.
Yeah.
Wow.
Right. So that is happening, and we are happy we are able to bring. So my CTO comes from US. So now he is kind of a US citizen, came back to India after 13 years in US.
And he's based in Indore.
Yes, he is working from Indore.
Right. Nice.
So that like reverse brain drain is also happening now, and it is helping us to reduce the next level brain drain in tier 2. And at the same time, we are focused on contacting the people who are talented and smart people from the city, went out, we talked to them, do you want to come back to Indore? And yes, there are few people who came back.
Okay.
And I am also one of
them. Yeah, you're also one of them, yes. So that's great. I think that whole ecosystem of startups in cities like Indore, Jaipur, Kochi is becoming a big center, etc. is also adding to it. Plus, all these big companies are also opening up centers in these cities, right? So,
right.
Whether it's a TCS or an Infosys or an Accenture,
yes.
They also see the value of the talent in these cities. And
yeah.
I think the whole thing of running an operation from an Indore is actually much lesser than running it, say, from a Bangalore.
Yeah.
And so that kind of really helps.
Yes.
So and from any the plans cost, for your company, sorry, to move to a Bombay and Bangalore as well?
So we ourselves position ourselves as a tier 2 focused e-commerce company, to be very honest. So no plans, and obviously when you start raising funds and you feel a lot of things start happening, and you have a lot of meetings happening in tier 1 because a lot of your suppliers and clients and companies are from tier 1. So you feel a lot of pressure to go to tier 1. But as Shop Kirana, we have decided to be, because if you see pattern in US, in US, company do not move out of the town.
Yeah.
You go to Seattle or you go to smaller cities.
Yeah.
Like, so you go to Nike. Nike have their own town.
That's
so
right.
You come to my town is the philosophy. And that is what is the philosophy of Shop Kirana also.
Fantastic. That's true, actually. Yeah. They stay in their hometown,
obviously,
and
obviously.
Build a whole city around it.
So, you see, Amazon build their own city. And now Amazon decide which city will be the city.
That's right.
So, that is how it operates in US. But in India, people move towards kind of the attractive points, and then they feel we are lost.
Yeah,
right. So
that's true. Ma'am, what are you seeing as a trend? Are you seeing that there are more jobs coming up for your students in Indore itself, or at least in MP itself?
Yeah.
Is that changing?
The future is bright, sir. Future is really bright because Infosys, TCS, all are migrating towards Indore.
Right.
Many startup companies like you told us that many of them are transferred towards Indore. Previously, the persons or the students or the brilliant or the intelligence is migrated from Indore to tier 1 places. Now, from their tier 1, they are migrated towards Indore.
Right.
So, this is a success we are having.
Yeah. And that's a big shift from a few years ago.
Big shift.
Like you said, you know, the reverse brain drain, and
spring.
Not just between countries, but actually from city 1 to city 2.
Yes. Because Bangalore is going to be densely populated.
Yeah.
So most of the persons are working from home at the Bangalore itself. So if they work at home from Bangalore, so what's wrong if they work from Indore?
Yeah.
The same thing.
That's right. Internet is the same.
Yeah,
speeds are as good.
So the people are migrating from that places to the tier 2 places. You very well said. So Indore has a bright future. Don't worry about that. The students should not worry about it.
Yep. So stay in your own city and find your own job.
We have an industrial hub at Pithampur. We have the industrial hub for mechanical, for mechanical persons. If the development is there, so there is no problem for the civil engineering students. And for the softwares, Infosys and TCS are migrating towards Indore. So I don't think there is any problem.
Right. So that's great. So which means that we're going to multiply the talent success story we've had in the big cities with all these big companies now, multiplying across so many more cities, not just say a handful of four or five.
Yeah.
Wonderful. So here's a question that we've already got from the from Facebook. And that's a reminder again, in case you have any questions, please put it up on the comment section or write to us on the CoCube Facebook page and we'll take it up right now. We've got one question out here. It says, if I'm from tier two or tier three city, how do I know where I stand among the competition from tier one cities? You want to try and answer this?
Yeah. What exactly the question?
The question is that if I'm from tier two or a tier three city,
how do I
know where I stand among the competition from tier one cities?
There is no issue. You may go through pre-assessment test. You will see the students are from tier one also, from tier two also, from tier three. All the students are appearing in that test. You will get your position there.
Yeah. What's your view?
See, I do not know on the aptitude or a kind of how you can measure yourself in terms of how much confidence you have. I don't know how you compare that. But on skill set side, obviously, if you see, like, the people are very much connected now. When you talk to people and you can go to online assessment of the skill set, and there you can judge on a skill set level at least. If you are a planner or an architect or a designer, first you have to be very, very clear what is skill set you want to compare yourself.
Yeah.
And in that skill set, you can obviously go online and in the digital connect where you are standing, you can compare and let yourself know.
Absolutely. And I think pre-assess is one tool. And then you yourself have to also measure up to see where you stand. It's not about how you measure up to tier one. It's not that everyone in tier one is great, right? So you have to see yourself whether you're making the cut in the area you want to make it in and prepare for that. So I guess we are close to closing time. What's your final message, Ritik, for everyone?
For everyone appearing this year for placement, I want to say that don't be disheartened after not getting placed in three or four companies, because there are a lot more opportunity. If you have talent, then it will definitely come out and you will definitely get placed in a very good company. So don't think like grab each and every opportunity like that you are not leaving one or two company. You have to appear in each and every company, not like that, no, I'm not going in this company, like 1,000 students are coming there and only they will pick only one students.
It's basically a learning process.
Yes, ma'am, right. Definitely. Because everyone's thinking is same. So you have to think different and you have to be like that, yes, I will be the one person. And you have to try hard and you have to not disheartened like, no, you will try out next or better. I am here live example. After getting my first placement done after 15 or 16 rejections. So yes, be confident and appear. All the best to all of you. Thank you, sir.
Wonderful. There's actually a question for you, Deepak. Yeah. Looks like you might have someone who wants to join you. So he says, please explain the Shop Kirana business model and concept.
Okay, so Shop Kirana, on top of everything, we are kind of empowering small retailers. We believe into new retail and we are a technology and supply chain company. So what Shop Kirana is building is a technology platform which can help small retailers to come on the next generation platform and use the next generation technology for their procurement, order processing or customer service. And at the same time, we are bringing the platform in market. We are bringing supply chain also in market. So Shop Kirana have its own fulfillment centers and supply chain, because India lacks a lot of supply chain infrastructure. So we are building that infrastructure majorly into tier twos.
Okay, great. So hopefully that answers your question, whoever asked that question. Yes, I'm doing. Okay, so people in this room, are you awake and are you interested in the story that's going on right now?
Yes, sir.
Any questions for the people here on this panel? Just raise your hand, we'll get you a mic. Okay, we got a mic for you. Yeah, go ahead.
Deepak sir, I have a question for you. So, as there are many e-commerce companies up there today, so setting up a new e-commerce company in that cluster, what were the key challenges that you face in the starting?
See, first is, as you mentioned, there were so many e-commerce companies.
Yes,
first is to define what kind of commerce you want to put in place. So, yes, there are so many B2C commerce companies, and Shop Kirana came with a new idea of B2B commerce. So, basically helping businesses only to connect, not consumer to connect to a business, but helping one business person to connect with another business person to do a commerce between them. So that is what
it's
we
a,
do.
It's a different
it's
idea.
It's a totally different, it's a idea,
different,
right?
Different idea.
And yes, there are challenges to explain a new idea, and that happened with us. But other than that, I think it was an open space for us.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other questions? Okay. Can we get a mic there, please?
Sir, I have a question that if I have an idea and I have formatted it in a file or some text format, then how should I, where should I go and how, which people I should meet to get a fund from him? How to impress somebody to get a fund in my company, initial fund?
Yeah.
How should I get?
Fantastic. So you're looking to be an entrepreneur.
Okay, I'll answer this.
Great.
I'll answer. In our college, we have one cell that was called as Innovation and Entrepreneurship Development. Hana? We run this IDC cell since last 5 years, and it is sponsored by DST, that is Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. Now we have another cell that is sponsored by MSME, that is also an incubation cell, where you get a seed fund of minimum 5 to 10 lakhs. Apart from this, IPS Academy initiated an incubation cell. The minimum funding is 25 lakhs, which was announced in few days back by our president that the seed amount is increased up to 50 lakhs.
Wow.
So don't worry about the funding. You just come with your idea. If you prove yourself, we arrange regularly arranged meetings. We call the CA, we call the industrialist, we call the investors, we call the academicians who analyze your project, who analyze your idea and support you for coming to the platform.
Ma'am, after college or after M.Tech, when I am totally confirmed that I have establish.
Yeah, in MSME, there is no limitation that you belong to this institute itself.
Okay, ma'am.
You belong to another institute, then also you will get the fund. If you belong to another, you are not an engineer, then also you will get the fund. The objective is to uplift the regional area, the region of Indore. The basic objective
okay.
is. So we belong to any place, it doesn't matter. Your idea should be fantastic. If your idea is fantastic, nobody stops you, you will get the fund.
Okay. Thanks, ma'am.
Okay.
Great. So we will have an entrepreneur, one more entrepreneur. We have one here. Maybe we'll have one more very soon. Great. Any other questions? Yeah, you got a question here?
So what is the time period for which CoCube?
One second. Yeah.
What is the time period for which CoCube will share the scorecard and student data with the company?
Sorry, can you repeat that question?
So time period for which CoCube will share the data, student data and the scorecard with the company?
So we'll answer that separately for you. Yeah? Because it depends on different programs that we run.
She is expecting
from CoCubes.
No need to worry about it. Everything is available on the website. If you have any problem, you can contact us also.
Right. Great. So we now also have with us the chairperson of the IPS Academy. Hi. This is Mr. Chaudhary. He's an architect by education and profession, and his other passion obviously is education, and he's been running schools and a lot of technical institutes. So the first question to you, sir, is that why did you decide to open up educational institutions in Indore?
The basic reason When I came to Indore, I had nothing. Indore gave me a lot of things. So I thought of repaying to the society. And when you go for a short-term thing, you know, you maybe you do some charitable work, maybe you plant trees. But if you really want to do something for the nation, something for the society, which goes on for years, means period, so I think education is the best thing. And that's why myself and my entire family went into for education.
Okay. So this is a city of dreams for you.
Yeah, definitely.
Right. So, you know, this whole discussion that we're having is around the talent goldmine that is there in tier 2 and tier 3 cities. Right. So what's your take on it? I think what we've discussed, and you know, we've had an interesting discussion about the fact that technology is enabling it, infrastructure is enabling it. A lot of corporates are seeing value in coming and working from tier 1 and tier 2 and tier 3 cities. What is your take on this? How do you see this coming out as a trend today? Are you seeing a different change in the last few years as compared to when you started out?
I'll go back to almost about 50 years. My basic education was from a village where the population was 10,000. And still the population is 10,000.
What village is that?
That is Rampura near Gandhi Sagar Dam.
Okay.
The point is, we had nothing. So our aspiration was this high. Nowadays, the facilities are lots of, lot of facilities are there. So the expectation should be much higher.
Right.
Now the tier one city, metro cities, there the facilities are of a very high level.
Right.
But the expectations are not that high. So still there is an opportunity for two-tier cities, the B-level cities, to aspire for something good.
Right. And what do you think is, you know, so everyone talks about, you know, that the next wave is going to be in tier 2 and tier 3 cities for India, because we've had saturation, we've had a lot more of people moving into those cities, and there's only so much that they can take, etc. In terms of talent, in terms of engineering talent or graduate talent in say a city like Indore, what do you think is special about it?
Would you repeat the question?
Yeah, so the question is that what is special about say tier 2 and tier 3 city talent, all the wonderful young people who are there in these cities, what's that one thing that they you know, if I was talking to a corporate, for example, how would I, what should I tell them that this is the gold mine that you have here?
See, there is a lot of influx from the nearby rural areas.
Right.
Now the children from these rural areas, they have lots of aspirations. They want to do something. They want to achieve something. So that's how the gold mine comes into these tier 2 cities.
Right. Okay, great. So what's your one message for our audience? And this is a lot of people from all over India, aspirants from engineering colleges who are looking to find their first jobs. What's your message for them as they're looking out to get that first job?
There's no shortcut to success.
Yes.
You have to work hard, you have to sweat. And if you don't work hard to fulfill your dreams, you'll actually end up working for somebody else's dream.
Yeah, that's a powerful one. It has nothing to do with the city. It has nothing to do with where you come from. It's really where you want to go and what you're doing with it, right?
Means, I'm proud. I come from that
village
and now this is where I am.
Yeah,
just as so many audience are there. And for all my budding talent and the students, when I came to Indore, I had a second-hand ladies bicycle on which I started my practice. It's means get grace of God and the hard work and the well wishes of all my friends and relatives that I have reached this level without any hanky panky work.
Fantastic. And I think that's a success story, and you're looking to multiply those success stories from all the institutes that you're running and all the people we have here. So that's a multiplier effect of all the success stories that you've had, that Deepak has had, that you will have, and yeah, so we'll take it from there. Thank you so much.
Just to mention, coincidentally, I had the schooling from the same place that you come from. So I had my schooling from Rampura.
Wow. Which year?
2004.
Wow.
So I left actually connecting offline in an online show.
Yes, yes.
On a small world.
Yeah, it's a small world. But so Rampura has given a lot of talents, and they most of them are in Indore.
Yes, yes.
Great. So what's your final message, Deepak, for everyone?
I think two things. One is obviously where you want to go, that has to be very clear. And what is your, see, aspirations should be there, but what is your skill set? Because a carpenter can make 500 rupees a day, at least with a basic skill set. A painter can make today 700 rupees a day. What is your skill set? And that has to be very, very clear. You are a planner, architect, designer. Can you ensure your survival with this skill set? Then aspirations are there.
Great. Ma'am, what's your... Yes.
See, time is the most important factor. All of us have 24 hours in a day. Now, how you spend? So you have to use your time just like you use your bank balance. So spend it correctly. Spend as less time in your sleep as possible. So dream means sleepless nights, dream high, and achieve what you want.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Great.
Yeah. So, sir, correctly said, you should have a big dream which doesn't allow you to sleep. Dedication, and the most important thing, desire, and strong desire and dedication. This makes you successful in your life. Don't worry about anything. Don't worry about from where you get the fund or whatever else. You will get the fund. If you have an idea, you definitely nurture it, and one day you will be a big successful one. We have the legendary like Achal Chaudhary sir with us. He shared his story with you. So nobody stops you. You have to work hard, be focused, and contribute at least Delta X daily towards your mission.
This I have been repeating time and again. So just for the information of you all, IPS Academy has an incubation center which has a fund of 25 lakhs per year. This is where we support innovative ideas. So all of you are welcome to come up with new ideas, and we'll come forward to help you out. Best of luck to all of you.
That's a big offer. So all those who are listening in, here's an offer. In case you want to be an entrepreneur, you can reach out to Mr. Chaudhary and see your dreams fly.
And one thing I would like to share, add in this, IPS believes in family. So IPS Academy is a family. That means you are the member of IPS family once you join IPS Academy. When you are leaving IPS Academy, then also you will be the member of IPS Academy. So when you wanted to join anything or you wanted to start your incubation after passing out, then also you are most welcome. Because you are the member of our academy.
Great. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone. And thank you, folks out here, for joining in. And as we always close with a quote, big cities, small cities, big dreams. So there are only two options. The quote is, there are only two options, make progress or make excuses. So make your own success stories, big city, tier one, tier two, small city, doesn't matter. We've got success stories out here, sitting out here with me. So go ahead and do that stuff, get that first job or get that first business going. All it needs is to make regular disciplined progress. So thank you very much for watching us, and we'll join you again next Wednesday for First Job Talks. And this conversation continues in the comment section of Facebook. So please do write in, and if you have questions for this panel, we can take it offline as well on Facebook. And do like this page so that you can keep getting updates about the next First Job Talks that we do. Thank you very much and have a good day. Bye.